With the new year approaching, everyone is going to start dieting, so I wanted to hop on here and talk about why restrictive dieting is actually bad for your health. So dieting in general can really have a negative effect when you're constantly searching for the quick fix filled with tons of restrictions. So we've all heard of the diets, keto and paleo, Atkins, South Beach, you name it. All of those diets have one thing in common, and it's just restricting your body from calories and certain food groups. So those diets will in fact help you lose weight fast, which people like because we live in a world of instant gratification, but they don't help you lose weight forever. So I'm sure we could all agree, we all know someone who's lost a ton of weight in 1 to 2 months, and then a few months later, they gained it all back plus more. You can gain back between 20, 30, 40, even 50 pounds more than where you were originally when you do the quick fix. So restrictive dieting works in the short term, which is why people like it, but the negative effect is it doesn't work in the long term. So it actually makes matters worse when you're doing restrictive dieting because it leads to yo-yo dieting. So when you create large shifts in your eating habits, not only do you get stuck in the yo-yo diet cycle of losing weight, but you're now gaining it back and it makes you gain back more while messing up your metabolism. It wreaks havoc on your gut health, let alone the mental exhaustion and frustration that comes along with all the inconsistencies and the disappointments after, you know, all your efforts are put in. Now, your intentions are good. Of course, everyone's intentions are good when they're trying to diet and lose weight. You're trying to better your life, you're trying to better your health, but when you do it and it's not giving you the result you wanted or the results you thought, it's because it's too extreme from what you were doing. So I wanted to share why you should say goodbye to your unhealthy diet plans if you're someone looking for long-term results, a permanent solution, and if you're really just looking to also improve your overall health along with your weight loss. So if you follow a restrictive dieting plan, you will end up with a slow metabolism, which we don't want, because when you start eating significantly less, your body thinks, okay, well, now I can cut the number of calories I burn in a day too because I'm eating less. Now, your body then goes into starvation mode when it realizes that the incoming energy is a lot lower than what it was before. So even if you plan on eating 3 times a day and they're all salads, you're not going to lose weight, and it's because your body is no longer burning the same amount of calories that it was. So it may work for the short term, but it's not gonna work for the long time because over time your metabolism is gonna get slower. So secondly, the negative of restrictive dieting is our gut health, because our gut health can really be a reason why, you know, we're gaining more weight and why more pounds are jumping on despite all of our effort in the gym and despite all of our nutritional efforts. So to keep it simply, when we gain weight, our microbiome changes and we develop more of a certain type of gut bacteria that supports the weight gain. However, when we lose weight, your microbiome is going to be slower to catch up, which means, and this is really important to realize, if you're starting to lose and gain weight rapidly in a yo-yo diet phase, your bacteria in your gut from the prior weight gain is now speeding up the process of adding on more weight, causing more than you had prior. So although you want to lose weight fast, because we live in a world where we need everything fast, 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 you also have to realize that losing weight fast is going to destroy your gut microbiome, and that's what's also going to stop you from being able to losing the weight you want. So not only does following an unhealthy diet plan have physical repercussions, but it's also horrible for your mental health. And I'm sure you could figure out a bunch of different reasons on why, but when you're continuously losing weight and gaining weight and then staying stuck, yo-yo dieting, there's studies, it leads to depression, lower self-esteem. It also affects our serotonin, which is responsible for our mood and our sleep. So this is where things can actually take a turn for the worse, because if you're constantly putting your body in, you know, high amounts of stress emotionally, this will actually cause your body to feel as if you kind of hit a wall and there's no turning back. You get frustrated, you get overwhelmed. So you may be asking yourself, what should you do next? So there is good news because there are ways for you to lose weight and reach your fitness goals without having to diet. Because there's really a big difference between going on a diet and, you know, adapting a new lifestyle. And a diet is temporary and a lifestyle is forever. So at the end of the day, although everything is really contradicting on the internet these days, simplicity always wins. And the solution that will save you time and energy all while getting you to the result that you want is really implementing small shifts in your habits. So small, healthier choices over time will bring you the long-lasting weight loss you always wanted without having to jeopardize your health. So whenever you're starting a diet, our intentions are always good. It's always really to, it's the start of something new, a better you, better choices, better health. So I do want to congratulate you and anyone who makes strides to bettering themselves, but you just want to make sure you're following a plan for greatness and success and not a plan that will move you in the opposite direction, because I do see it far too often just from misinformation and just the wrong coaching, for following the plan. So if you liked this video, please take the time to like it, comment below, share it with anyone you feel would get some value from this. Tomorrow, join me again because I'm actually going to be talking about why cardio is making you fat. You may hear that and be shocked because you always thought that cardio is the key to weight loss. But tomorrow I'll be sharing why that's not always the case. So I'm looking forward to seeing you then, and I hope you have a great day.